What's going on, everyone? Happy holidays. I hope you all are doing well and staying safe. And when I say everyone, I mean my 5 subscribers.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Anyways, today I thought I would do a review on the Edifier R1700 Bluetooth speakers. Now, these are actually the monitors I use in my own setup. They're a great affordable option. They sound and look great for the price. And if you're looking for Christmas gift ideas or you want to buy something for yourself because you need to spoil yourself, you deserve it. These are a great option whether you want to create music, create videos, or just listen to music, watch stuff casually. These are a great option for the price. Now, I just want to mention that I have the BT speakers. Edifier also has a BTS version of the speakers, which basically just has updated Bluetooth and an updated wireless remote and a couple other minor differences, but there's really no difference in the actual sound quality of the speakers. So this review is still applicable for both of those options, but I will link both options in the description below. The updated speakers are $10 more, so it's really up to you whether you want to spend that extra $10 or not for the updated features. If you didn't know already, which you probably didn't, my name's Ryan. I'm a freshman college student studying computer science at William & Mary. I make videos on technology, coding, and lifestyle. So if that sounds like something you'd be interested in, please hit the subscribe button and turn your bell notifications on. That would be much appreciated. I'll be posting 2 or 3 times a week. I would love for you to join. Please join. By the way, if you like what you see with the speakers or any of the tech that I use in my setup, check the description below because I will be linking all of these products, their Amazon links, so you can check them out for yourself. Just know that if you do end up purchasing something using those links, I will get a small cut of that, and that would really help me out because I'm a broke college student. All right, enough chit chat. Let's get to these speakers. First, I want to talk about the design. These studio monitors, in my opinion, are one of the best looking ones out there. They have a beautiful wooden finish that really makes them look high quality and gives them a premium feel. If you're someone who likes tech that makes your workspace look more natural and inviting, trust me, these are the monitors to go with if you're on a budget. For me personally, these monitors fit right in with my Salt Lamp and Google Home Mini, which kind of looks like a pebble. Now, obviously, this nature look is not for everyone, but in my opinion, it's a pretty versatile look that can be used in a lot of different scenarios. But yeah, big fan of how these speakers look. I think they did a great job making them look high quality. They definitely look more expensive than they actually are. So they look great, but how do they sound? Let's get down to the nitty-gritty technical details first, and then we'll do a sound test. So the R1700BTs have digital signal processing and dynamic range control built in. Basically, these are in place to prevent distortion in the noise. Now, these speakers have 19mm dome tweeters and a 4-inch bass driver in each speaker. According to Edifier, the tweeter and bass driver create rich lows and clear highs. The front-facing bass reflex port, which is the big circular black hole at the bottom, emphasizes the low frequencies and give the bass a nice boost. So those are the technical details. Let's get into the sound test. I'm going to be using my Samson Pro microphone for the sound test of this video. right. So that was the sound test for the speakers. They sound really great for the price. There's no distortion even at the higher sound levels, and the bass and treble sound great. They can also get really loud, like really loud. These things get f***ing loud. All right, so now that we've done a sound test of the speakers, let's talk about the features that these studio monitors have. Because for the price, they actually have quite a lot of features. So one of the smaller features of these monitors, and I don't even know if I would call it a feature, but they come with these mesh protective covers. These are able to be off or on, and you can attach them with the four pegs that are on the front of both monitors. Now, these protect the front of the monitor from dust and other unwanted scenarios, and they also just give them a different look. So I didn't notice any difference in sound with these on or off, so it's really up to you whether you want these on or off, depending on what look you're going for and depending on, you know, the room that you're in. These studio monitors also come with three dials on the side of one of the speakers, and you can use these dials to change the treble, bass, and volume levels easily. Now, these do work correctly, but I find myself leaving these at default most of the time, but your experience may vary. Now let's talk about the remote, and with that, the Bluetooth capability of these speakers, because that is a huge draw for people that are looking at these speakers specifically. So a wireless remote is included in the box with buttons to turn the speakers on and off, mute the volume, turn the volume up and down, and switch between Bluetooth and wired connection. So for example, I plug my computer into the speakers and use them for editing or other tasks. And then when I want to sit back and listen to music, I'll switch over to my phone and use the Bluetooth connection. So that's one of the best things about these monitors. You can connect these using a wire to the PC and use the Bluetooth at the same time with another device. There's really a lot of options that the added Bluetooth capability gives to these speakers, which I think gives it a lot more value. Let's talk about durability and the longevity of these speakers. Now, I've had these speakers for about a year now, and I've seen no signs of exterior wear and tear. They've held up perfectly. They also sound just as good as they did when I picked them up. I haven't noticed any deterioration of sound quality with these speakers. The remote also still works perfectly, so I've had no problems there. It connects to the speakers just fine, and the battery hasn't run out yet. So if you're looking for a pair of budget studio monitors that will last you a long time, I would definitely recommend these speakers because I've had no problems with them at all in terms of durability. All right, so taking all of that into consideration, would I recommend these studio monitors to you for the holidays and 2021 year? And the answer is yes, absolutely. At $150 for the BT version and $160 for the BTS version, these studios are, in my opinion, absolutely worth the price. I'm a huge fan of how they sound and look, and the Bluetooth is just an added bonus that makes these even more useful than they already were. Now, I know everybody has different opinions, and some people might not like the wooden finish of these monitors. That's totally fine, but come on. I mean, how can you not like the look of these? They're beautiful. So anyways, yes, I do recommend these speakers, and yes, you can find the link to the BT and BTS version in the description down below if you're interested in picking these up for yourself or for the holidays as a gift for someone else. Thanks so much for watching my review on the R1700 Bluetooth speakers. I hope this was helpful and gave you an idea of whether these speakers are right for you. Once again, my name's Ryan. I make videos on tech, coding, and lifestyle. So if you'd like to see future videos, make sure to subscribe and turn your bell notifications on so you're notified when I post a new video. I'll be doing videos on all of the tech in my setup over the next couple weeks, so be sure to stick around for that. All right, I will see you in the next video.